Congressional delegation, and I'm grateful for their help and support and for the way they represent their state in Washington. Of our hearts, thank you all for your very warm welcome. Word on whether the meetings were a success or not this morning, it seems the TASS, the Russian news agency, says that I was a failure at trying to eat a pigeon egg with my chopsticks. We traveled almost 20,000 miles to Hawaii, Guam, and finally China, to the cities of Beijing, Xi'an, and Shanghai. We saw the wonders of that country and the fine antiquities of the old civilization. And I think the best moment was late last night, or I should say early this morning. And I had it all in mind that I was going to talk about coming through the darkness and then finally seeing the lights of the coast, Alaska down below, and the coastline there, and that we knew that we were seeing America again and we were home. Well, there was a cloud cover all the way over the Pacific Ocean. So the lights. About the American soldiers returning from the trenches in the First World War. They admired the grandeur and the oldness of Europe, but their hearts longed for the newness of their own country. And upon their return, in that poem they said, "So it's home again and home again, America for me. My heart is turning home again, and there I long to be. The blessed land of room enough beyond the ocean bars, where the air is full of sunlight."
everyone please stand and let's all join in singing the Alaska flag song.
Right. I want to welcome your holiness to the United States. And on behalf of the American people, say how pleased and privileged we are to have you on. We're just returning from a mission of peace, and I can think of no more fitting place for this journey than to be here, especially to your holiness and for peace among nations. And appreciation for the unalienable rights of every human being is a very concept that would transcend the claims of any government, and that this transcendent right itself has a transcendent soul. Our Declaration of Independence, fourth amendment, one of our greatest presidents, Thomas Jefferson, put it simply, the God who gave us life gave us liberty at the same time. When I began this journey, I asked to speak to the world, renounce the agony and heartbreak of war, and learn to live in love with each other. Only when the fellowship of all, and your visit is particularly significant, coming to God soon after the reestablishment of the world. In a violent world, Your Holiness, you have been a minister of peace and love. Your word is true, and we wish you every encouragement in your journeys for peace and understanding in the world. I also learn to the Holy See and to the United States. We deeply value your counsel and support and express to the American people. I welcome you and I extend to you.
I thank you for your kind welcome on my arrival.
Embajador norteamericano ante el Vaticano.
I also extend my good wishes to Bishop Kanielski on this happy occasion. When I arrived for my first visit to your beautiful state, who reached out and handed me a bouquet state flower. Shall give you the assurance that I have not forgotten you. Even when I am miles away, in some ways, Alaska President Reagan is returning from visiting the beloved people of China. This vast state, six diverse backgrounds, find a common home. Each person, each family, is challenged to achieve this aim. Some openness to each other. And the power of each is an ability to listen
Solidarity between the rich and the
poor, which pervades this region.
The blessings that you yourselves have received in abundance. God bless you. Thank you.